So how do we do this? Well, we find the smallest element, and we know that it must move to the smallest output location. So in that case, that's going to be a zero here. This is the smallest element out of all of these. It's going to be scattered to output location zero. The next smallest element is here, and then here, and then here, and then here, 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 and here. So the key here is, how do we get these numbers? That's the important part of the merge algorithm here. So we're going to put ourselves in the mental position of one of these elements in the first list. So we're going to pick this particular element right here. And we're going to say, hey, what position am I in my own list? Well, I'm a position 2 because there are 2 elements in front of me in my list. So he would be at position 0, he would be at position 1, and I'm at position 2. Now, here's the cool part. This guy has to ask, where would I be in the other list? Well, if I look at this list, I would need to be right here. So if I was in that list, I would also be at position number 2 because there would be 2 elements in front of me. This guy would be at position 0, this guy would be at position 1, and I would be at position 2. So in the overall list, I know I'm behind 2 elements here, and I know I'm behind 2 elements here, so I can add those things together and discover that in the final sorted list, I would be at position number 4. And that is the scatter address that I need to put him in the right position in the output list. So how do we know our position in our own list? Well, that's very simple. We've launched these threads as a contiguous block with 1 element per thread. So I'm going to be exactly at my thread ID. He's thread ID 0, he's thread ID 1, and he's thread ID 2. So how do we know our position in the other list? That's a little bit more complex. What we need to do to make this work is to do a binary search in the other list. So this element will look in the other list, move down as a binary search until it finds out where it's going to belong in the other list. Every thread does an independent binary search in parallel in the other list. So for a sorted list of length n, that will take log n steps per element, and all of those elements will do the search in parallel. And that's a very fast operation if we're doing it out of shared memory. Now, for sorting more elements that can fit in shared memory, then what we generally do is read in only a chunk of each sorted list, compute the first part of the output, write it back into main memory, refill the input arrays with more elements, and repeat until done.